Happy Tuesday, y'all. So today I'm going to be doing a video of my Chico. I love this dog. He is very, very spicy. I'm the only one that can groom him. So I'm going to let y'all in, see how he does. I've been doing him for quite a while now. Whenever he comes in, we cannot take the... I always tell the girls don't take the collar off. Just throw the leash in there. Because he will bite somebody. And I don't think it's out of aggression. It's mainly out of fear. Sometimes he nips at me. Sometimes he's okay with it. He's a very sweet boy. He just misunderstood, that's all. So we're gonna put him in the tub. I gotta take off his leash.
Hello, buddy. It's okay.
No. So we're gonna give him a wash, let him dry, do all that fun stuff. Now he was put on another groomer, but I have alerts in the computer to say he's put it on me. Okay. So let me put it on the front, because I'm not sure if they know about the alert. But I'm gonna wash him down, shampoo him. And I have to see if he's gonna use his counter pad or if he's putting them all over us. Just because the weather is giving him a lot of itchies, I'm gonna use our oatmeal. Getting him to come over here. He was fight. So I'm very, very proud of the success that we've had so far. Just to be able to do this without, you know, being stressed out and freaking. And I know a lot of people in this room said, well, today, I don't believe in sedating unless the dog is absolutely 100% amazing. One, it's very costly. But the main issue is, every time you put a dog under to go to sleep in his room, you're taking a risk. And I'm not that kind of girl to put a risk on your dog's body. But you never know. You might put a dog to sleep just one time, just to, you know, get the groom done, and then it's like you have to do it every single time. It's not helping the dog. It's not teaching the dog that they need to like the groom. They need to get used to the groom. They need to trust that groomer. Oh, Katie. So that's why I don't stay. Unless I really, really have to. So we're going to go around the house. We're going to put this over your head, okay? It's not a muzzle. It's not a muzzle. See? Woo! See? It's not a muzzle. Put it over your head. Okay, trust me.
Going up. We're going up.
regarding acne. I know.
You've been scratching back here. Yeah. You've got some itchies. You've got some itchy scratchies.
You've got some itchy scratchies.
I love you. Okay. Now, last time I shaved him, because he was really mad. So since his legs are in good condition, we are going to do a number 7. On his back, put him back in the schnauzer pattern. Alright, buddy, gotta put my hand underneath you, okay? Okay. Just on the brush. I got you, buddy. Okay. Good boy. See all the bumps on his back from where he's been scratching. You see all the itchy scratches.
You can tell the way for the back too.
Well, that's what you can tell, buddy. Okay?
Good boy. Good boy.
It doesn't matter. It's taking his. This part down a little bit slower. Back.
any bones.
I groomed this cat years ago, and they used to show it in 4-H, and she had, the problem is, so I have a cat that has an 18-inch tail that we don't want anything cut off of, and she went through to the show, and I was like, oh my god, it's so funny.
Okay.
You see your leash in college there. I'm so proud of you. Do you know that? I'm so proud of you, Chico. Yeah. Yeah. Can you get your chest okay? In the shower, you technically should not go down all the way down to the nose. I do that just because on him, just because he sometimes will not go down there. It's a little bit easier to keep that area a little bit cleaner. Thank you.
cute little boy. I love my Chico Man. I love my Chico Man. I never let him go.
We're gonna do your private areas, okay?
This is a 10, a number 10.
Boy. You got hair in your mouth? Come here. You got hair in your into your feet now, okay? No. Buddy. No. 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 I know you don't like your feet done, I know. I know. And I believe it.
You know I gotta get those feet. You know I gotta get those feet.
Come on.
Ha! No, don't be nasty. Don't be nasty. Don't be nasty.
Pretty much all I really do, but do what he lets me do. Just to take a little bit of length off. It probably won't take much off. No, that's fine. I don't want too much taken off anyway.
Hey, baby, do you know how to print out the vaccination?
He knows. Come on. Hey! Look here, you little stinker. Come on, turn around.
I believe in love him.
All of him.
He was just a misunderstand boy. And when anybody tries to talk smack about him, I'm like, y'all just gonna get him.
Made out the muslin for his nails. We'll see. I'm trying not to muzzle him. Let's make some noise. And I'm not trying to go backwards. Some people be like, well, maybe today. They're calling on me earlier. I'm not that hungry. I'm not that hungry. But if I have to study your cat or your dog, then it's more of a risk for both of us. I'd be mad, I'd be upset, but I'd get over it. I know he doesn't mean it. I know he's coming from a place of, you know, he just knows. He's just a little scared bugger. I got my rabies shot last year. It was a set of three.
How long
did it last? Tell people. I don't know. A 10th
pick to ask. Yeah. When did it let expire?
Do I need to come back in and get another rabies shot?
You did it
3 years. Yeah, last year I got bit by a cat. I did a video on that cat. It was crap for me. That's back when I was doing my lives. Beat me on my lives. My arms swelled up. I had to get a rabies shot. I told them that, you know, it was my cat that we had taken in. Yeah, but it was a stray or whatever. And we had given it shots and stuff like that. And they're like, well, you have to give you a rabies shot in just to be on the safe side. And then I had to get my tetanus shot redone. I am not a fan of the tetanus shots.
No problem.
Thank you.
date. We're gonna have to change that because, like, it says 11/16/22, due date 10/7. I should probably change that or else they won't accept it. It's like this campground woman is like, is the only one I've ever, like, seen that will, like, ask for your shot.
Probably.
And they actually require the board to tell it. And I've never seen anything, any place like that require a board to tell it. The only place I've ever seen that's required to tell it is like a boarding facility, you know?
Yeah. I wonder if it's because maybe the dog's going to get sick.
Or because it's like at the Keys. So it's an island, so I wonder if that's why.
That could be why too.
Because, you know, if anything happens on the island, it takes out the whole island.
I'm gonna go to the island.
They also don't let you have fires.
Well.
Fire pit.
Yeah, but you're like, on an island, there's water. I don't think you need to go that far.
Yeah, it's on the Navy Day, so like, then you're not allowed to have firearms or weapons on the base either. And Clayton's like, well, I'm bringing my gun. Obviously, we're going to be in the Keys.
Yeah.
I'm totally not going to hurt you. You know, like, how do you bring that?
Can I see your foot? I know you're thinking about it. You're thinking about it. I want to hold your foot, but I don't want you to get upset with me. Folks, about you getting upset with me?
Okay, so they got their leftovers. I didn't even know they got the leftovers, so that's cool. And then this is another part of the leftover, too. And then Brian got the.
That's what I do. I'm like, whatever they need, just...
Oh my God, I'm pretty sure they're up today.
Do whatever you gotta do. No, I want to do this side.
Okay. We got this party animal sitting in
do a little tap dance with me. Coming out. No. You know you don't do that. You know you don't do that. You don't do that. See, he's sorry afterwards. He comes and gives me hugs.
No stinker.
So it wasn't me this time. No, I'm also going to sit down and have to muzzle him. Where are you going? Face first, and then we're going to muzzle him for his nails, and he's going to go very crazy. So he's going to be off for 2 weeks. Yep, she's going to an island. She's going to the Keys with her husband. Well, he's got some kind of military thing or something. Come on, so. Can I go?
I was going to say, shit, can we all go?
Shh. For real?
For real. Just be nice.
I know. I don't even have two pennies to rub together.
I said that to him and he said, two pennies? I said, yeah, because we got poor right now. The money goes out to bills, and then it's like, what I got left?
I want a weekend vacation. I need another weekend to get over it.
Shoot.
It was that damn boring and bad and aggravating. The hotel we stayed in was a hotel. It was lousy.
That stinks.
Expensive.
Yeah, I believe that.
And we're right down smack down in the middle of downtown Mobile where there's nothing.
Did you
leave? So you were stuck there. You didn't know where you were going to eat at their little stupid restaurant.
Oh, they didn't give you a breakfast in the morning?
No.
Man, see, whenever we look for hotels, we got to, Eric's like, I'm fat and I want breakfast in the morning, so they have to have breakfast.
Well, this is called the Admiral Hotel, downtown Mobile.
Oh, okay.
It's an old, look like an old building.
I'm like, I want some breakfast.
One little teeny tiny little ratty bar. It was supposed to be a / coffee and bar.
Oh, okay.
So, I think we paid $6 for a damn beer.
Jesus.
Yeah, because the convention room where we usually have our banquet.
Yeah.
They usually have like an on the side bartender, complimentary bar thing.
Not this year.
Which one's so bad? Hell, this thing was up on the second floor. The damn bar's down on the main lobby.
You're like, I ain't walking up those steps. I'll pay the $6.
I'm like, what the hell?
I want to ask one of my waiters, hey, did you go up those steps?
We went up there at 8 and hung around for a few seconds. We went downstairs and sat at the bar.
Do that.
To me, it wasn't fun at all.
Was the bed at least comfortable?
I'm not going to get in the van and go somewhere where I don't know where I'm going anyway. So he was stuck in meetings all day Saturday, so I was stuck there in the damn hotel, wherever the hell it was.
Yeah, Eric's like that too. If he don't know where he's going, he ain't going.
No gift shop, no nothing.
Not even a get wow.
Yeah, that's what I said, wow.
Usually they always have some kind of gift shop or some kind of store like that.
I told him, this next time you go do this again.
We stayed
at the Holiday Inn across the street.
Yeah, buddy. You get breakfast at the Holiday Inn. I know that because
I like Holiday Inns. I don't like stuffy old motels.
Yeah, I like the Holiday Inn too. And some of them have a pool.
It was kind of musty smelling, and I'm like, that didn't help.
Oh, yeah. Like,
oh my God. Really?
I would have complained.
No.
What? Change these sheets. They stink.
The ice machine on our floor didn't work, so I had to go either up or down one to get ice.
I swear, ice machines at hotels are like the ice cream machine at McDonald's. They're always never working.
Yeah.
What is this weird white spot right here? I hope that's not like a ringworm and I'm just like touching all over it. I don't think it is. I don't know what it is, buddy. I don't know what it is. Can I get this? Can I have the kisses? No.
Can you still drag the kid with her too?
Yeah.
Well, that's gonna be a long.
She's taking the dolls with her too. All three of them. Or is it four? Three or four, whatever. She's taking them with her too. She gotta get.
Josh.
Because it's a campground on the island that they're staying at, some kind of camper, I guess. She's like, you can't set fires. You can't bring firearms. And she said, Clay said he's bringing his firearm. They're in the keys. I'd bring it too. All right, buddy. I gotta grind your toes, and you're not gonna like this, so I'm gonna
We're gonna find a muzzle.
Oh wait, she's got one for me.
Stay right there, buddy.
I said stay right there. You gotta move, silly Nilly.
Small one, so what I'm gonna do is
what am I gonna do? I'm going to probably tighten this. I'm gonna start with these back feet. Like I said, don't go crooked.
Can you see this place over right there? I think it was a nipple or a mold or something I up here. I had to put a blood stop on it. It looked like a stuffed pig.
I don't think it was a nipple.
No. I think it might have been a nipple.
It seems fine, yes.
Is it not bleeding or is it?
Your mother-in-law cornered Dr. Moses in the parking lot and she's stalking you outside this door. She's wondering when you're going to get done.
Well, I still have one more after this. Careful. I
got
monsters.
But did you...
I still have no idea. Yeah, but she's got to pick up my kids because right now the car is out of commission.
Uh-huh.
And I can't get to the shop because I have money to fix it. I think it's probably the ride later.
Do you want me to tell her in a certain time or that you'll call her?
She's over here on this side?
Yeah, I just saw her driving. That was just the wrong way of traffic.
What are you doing? She was stopping.
Yeah, she's going that way.
Yeah, there you go. You came back here, it was in perfect time.
Okay, we're not gonna be bad though. You're a good baby. You're doing so good, Chico.
You
think
so great
today. It's okay. You're doing just fine, my love. I gotta
be
just for
a little bit better.
You're doing just fine, I've got them, so do what you got to. Good job, Chico. You're doing so good.
I'm not a big fan of getting this.
It's okay, Chico. Okay. I know. You're okay. You're okay, Chico. You're doing so good, love. You're doing so good.
He gives like the best hugs.
When he does something bad, he knows he does something bad, and he puts his head on my shoulder like, I'm really sorry.
Then you don't like it. Granted, like, when I think about it, like, I can't get pedicures because my feet are super tingly. So maybe it's like, I like to think that sometimes with dogs, like, I hate being tickled. I get violent when I get tickled. So maybe you too. You're alright, love. I know. She's almost done. The shorter she gets them, the less you have to come back. You're okay, my love.
That's what it is.
You're okay, love. You're doing so good.
Thanks, buddy.
Good job.
You did
good
so
job.
Good.
Alrighty.
Thanks. Good job, Chico.
Yeah, I'll go up there in a second because I'm sure she's probably not going to call me.
Yeah.
He did something. I'm so
proud. He did so good. He's so proud of you.
You did so good. You did so good, buddy.
Better than what I thought it was going to be. I'm very proud of him. I don't know if I had any videos of it when I first started doing him. I'm going to see if I can find one.
You did so good, Chico. I am so proud of you, Bubby. I am so proud of you. so good. You did so good. I love you.
We did a cute little schnauzer tuck. We can all set and ready. I'll see you later.